Hey, it's Patrick again from the Revamps Template Framework for Website Baker. And in this screencast, gonna tell you some more about the installation of the Revamps Template Framework 5 for Website Baker. And yeah, there's a lot of big change since the last screencast I published on YouTube. It's about 9 months ago. It was like September 2013. And it's now July 2014. And as I said, a lot's been changed. And one of the things that's been changed is the website. I mean, you can see there's a brand new Revamp 5 website. And it also makes like the Revamp's template framework as developed till it's now almost final distribution. It's at the moment it's in a pre-gold build state. But in a way, it's ready for like a month. It's stable, so it's probably going to be soon in as a final version. And what I'm going to show you is how to install, because I heard a lot from developers and from designers like, okay, it's nice, but how to install this this thing? So first of all, I will make this movie much shorter as the one before. So let's start with it. First of all, go to revamps.com, and there you'll see, of course, the nice photo shoot we had. But don't let it distract you. Let's go to the download section, and you'll notice some things have been changed. For example, there's now a tryout version. You can try the version of Revamps 5 for in a way, a certain period. It says here a half year license refresh, and it means as Revamps 5 is now licensed with a serial, which in a way check if the serial is valid, and then it will activate the template framework. It will be refreshed every half year, so you can try the version for a while. If you like it, you can purchase it for a certain website or multiple websites. And in a way, it's not like before, like you have like one license for multiple servers, but this is really like a server license. So a website server license, and as Revamps 5 enables you to have multiple websites on one Website Baker installation, this is how it works. If you want to have one website on Website Baker, you pay this price. If you want to have three websites, with various domains, of course. I mean, that's possible. You can have like three different domains redirecting to one Website Baker install, and have the three different websites with three different layouts or designs, how you call it. And you still can edit them from one Website Baker installation. It's pretty handy if, for example, if you get a certain website which got also a mobile website or also some sub-brands. You can all manage it from one Website Baker installation. And it goes up to like 10 websites. And of course you pay a little bit more if you want to have 10 websites on one Website Baker install, but that's logical. So let's first start to download the Revamps. It's still a pretty small file. Still about 3.5 MB, or better, this file is altogether 10 MB, but if you unzip it, you'll notice there's some files inside the folder. And the actual template is this file, the Revamps 5.zip, like 3.5 MB. First, what I want to advise you is to read the quick start, which is very important. Because one important thing is like there's a serial included, which you really need. Otherwise, you can install it and it just won't work. And second of all, it shows you how to set up the page structure. As I said in my on my website, it's like not like any other Website Baker template, but it's more like a framework. So it's really like a piece of software that's on top of Website Baker. It's completely standalone. It doesn't interact with the database or something. It's really on top of WebSocket, and therefore you need to have a certain structure to make it work properly, especially if you want to have, for example, multiple websites. So as you can see, you need to, or better say, it's handy to make for certain language or for certain websites, for the different menus, make their different root page trees, as I call them, for them. So if you want a top menu, you make a different routes for the top menu. If you want a sidebar menu, for example, you can make there another route. And they're from the base, they're from the root of the page structure. Well, here's some information. You can read it on yourself. There's also even some upgrade information. The one important thing is the serial. And we think we can copy it already. Then go to the WebSocket installation. I already set up a WebSocket site with a structure, and actually it's kind of clone from Revamps, so it's already a little bit optimized because the pages is already there, and it's like this. And for example, in this website I only have one menu, it's for the English version, and got all its pages under beneath it. This page is a menu link. So it's not a what you see what you get, but a menu link. So it doesn't have, let's say, content on it, but it redirects to the main. That's very important. And that I also did with the NL version, which is not finished yet, and the mobile version. And you can check out if you go with your mobile device to revamps.com. You'll see how this page is. And some other pages I'm busy with. So it's important to have this kind of structure, and that I'll show you later again. Well, we have downloaded the zip file, and if you expand that zip file, you notice these three files. So here are some additional schemes, which I'm probably gonna talk about in another movie. But this is the most important. This is what we're gonna install in WebSocket. So let's go to the add-ons, let's go to templates, and let's choose a file. You'll notice this folders, and here it is, Revamps 5, and we're going to choose this file. Click on install. As you notice, this is already the new version of WebSocket, as the 2.8.4, which is still in beta, but of course I already have to to check if it's gonna work out on the new upgrade of WebSocket. It will work definitely on the 2.8.3, and in a way it's kind of hard to make it working for 2.8.4, but it's been done. We can check if it's installed. You can see here it's Revamps. Let's see about the details. Revamps is the 5.0 pre RTE. For WebSocket 2.8.3, and it looks fine. As you notice, right now there's only this this default WebSocket template, which doesn't show all the content properly. Of course, it's already been made for the fact that I'm gonna install Revamps on this. On this particular install, and you notice that some although the pages already have content, it won't show up. For example, the main page got already content, but it's in other sections which are not available in this template. I mean, Revamps got like 7 content areas, and this template only got 1 or 2 or something, so they don't match yet. But let's apply the Revamps to the website. We go to the settings of WebSocket, and we choose Revamps and click save. if we now reload the website again, so we go to it, notice it will give you a notification like you need to enter a serial, and you need to of course allow pop-ups, because after this, if you click OK, there will be a pop-up, or better say new tab with configuration. Let's go to the quick start file, to the PDF, and copy this serial license and paste it there, and click OK. Well, it seems okay. You see, it will recognize your website baker directory. If you have installed website baker on a subdirectory, like /wb, you have to enter it here, and that's for later on. For now, we're gonna hide the alert dialog. That needs to be checked, so otherwise it will show you again the dialog, and there's no other workaround for doing this, so check this box. This should be fine. And also the menu root level, I set it to 1, because you see the pages are like 1 level deep. This is level 0, and the actual pages is like level 1. So it also says here is if the page on the root, you put a 0, otherwise 1 or etc. Well, for now, we're just gonna save it, and it'll probably give us an error, maybe not. Oh, it's okay. Depends a little bit on your server. And you notice like revamps, it's installed successfully. And it'll notice you if you do changes, save them with this. We go again to the general settings, and we can check here double, it's a valid license. The second thing we need to do, and that's also written in the PDF. It's like, well, first of all, we have to of course enter a domain name. Well, let's do that first. Because what I was talking at that is like we have to apply a modification to Website Baker in order to make it work properly. You have to only do it one time for the website, and then after that we add like multiple websites in revamps. And that's got to do with the domain forwarding. As it's possible to add multiple domains to revamps. Though Website Baker cannot handle that officially, with this kind of hack, it will. So it will not hard code the domain name in it, but we put it in the it's gonna be revamp's gonna take care for the domain forwarding. What we need to do is to add at least one website here, because otherwise you'll see if you now reload the website, it will say add a notification. Well, that we have to do it later. So we can just close this again, because it just won't work at this particular moment. And this may be a point where a lot of you think like, okay, it's not work. Well, the trick is add the domain name into the first website. As you can see, there's tabs here. These are the general settings, and these are the website settings. And we're gonna, for example, give this as this website is called Resense. We kind of call it Resense, and you'll see it's already there. And it's kind of, another version of revamps. And we can choose here a scheme. And schemes are, in a way, the skins or the themes of the website. So, as revamps is already a template on itself, it doesn't. But it's more like a framework. It doesn't have any style on itself. It's more like a framework, Inside the framework you have schemes, and the schemes are the styles. For now we choose revamped 5, and we have to put here an URL. Well, that's where we put like the resense.com, for example. And also, for safety, add there the resense with the www. Another important thing is like, it likes to know what's the main page. Well, that we already know, because this is going to be the main page, and we can probably will redirect again. That's not it. Now we can copy it from here, and we copy the part from the slash pages, and we come back again to the main page URL. So here we put the like pages and US main. That PHP as the main page URL, because then it knows where to redirects. Because the trick is revamps recognize this domain and knows it's website one, and it attaches this scheme to it. We can give here a language, for example, let's call it English, and you can do already some fancy things with it, like showing the language flags, and even if you got, for example, multiple languages. Remember this already been developed before Western Baker 284, where there was no language module inside. The new Western Baker does do some with languages, but here you can do it like show language flag, and if you got like three websites in one Western Baker install, like one is like English, other ones like German or Dutch, you can relate the websites. So right now we can relate 2 and 3, for example, if these are other languages, we can relate them. And of course here you can do it again. In website 2 you can say, okay, in website 2 I want to relate 1 and 3. And for example, if you give this another language, it will show all the flags and redirect them to the proper website or language. For now, we don't have yet this website, so I won't check them. But I'll relate website 1 with it, because it's got this, it's this website, so show the flag. For now, this is okay. So let's save the configuration. And you notice that, as I told you before, this is standalone, standalone web application. There were some questions in the beginning, like, okay, but you can exit if you go to this URL. And in the previous versions, you could change the settings, as I call it, the settings folder, because it's, as you can see, it's in the template of revamps in the template folder. Of Website Baker, there's the revamps folder, and inside there there's just this index. So I made this automatically generated SHA-256 tag which generates, and it's completely original, unique by every Website Baker install, so it should be hard guessing for someone to access this this environment, this configuration. So it's automatically generated, and you can change it if you want, but it's already good like this, so it's in a way as secure as some good passwords. Well, if you save it now and we go again to the recent website and we reload it, you notice something. This is how Revamp 5 comes out of the box. Default out of the box with this the cookie policy blah blah blah. And you notice there's already the menu items, very nice in the top menu, because that's how I already pre-configure it. And there's some other some text already on in certain sections. Well, I'm gonna show you a little bit how the revamp works, or how to assign sections to how to assign content sections Let's, for example, take the main page. If you edit this page, you notice there's a lot of different fields, a lot of what you see, what you get sections. And if you look at them, you notice like there's more sections as a common website baker template. I mean, we got a content top, a column left, a column right, content main, a sidebar left, a sidebar right, a content footer, and a hidden section, which is handy, for example, if you want to, if you got content or a certain section you just want to hide for a while, just select hidden section and your block is still there, and maybe later on you can move to the left, to the right, wherever you wanna. So I already made most of the pages like with content. And when you look at it, you notice some content is already there. It's not on the correct places, because this is what you see right now with the column left and the column right. It's like the default template from Revamps and the default scheme. But of course there are more schemes, and you can download them from the Revamp website. I now switch like to the Revamp website again. And you notice here there's some schemes. It's baby blue scheme. There's, for example, which got like it's kind of way derived from the default template like this. So I got left sidebar, right sidebar, content menu, content top, stuff like that. But there's also some nice ones. There's also like some for example mobile templates, which doesn't look like, it doesn't look nice like this, but if you look at on a smart device, it looks nice. It got transparency, it got a nice menu, and some pretty neat design. But there's also, for example, a vert scroller. This is, doesn't look pretty nice like this, because these images come from the scheme editor, which I'm gonna show you a little bit later on, or maybe in the next movie. These are just like the colors and the fonts and stuff like that. It's not the design, it's not the layout yet. So let's go back to the Revamps template. As told you, there are schemes, and right now, you know, it's like, okay, it's nice, but it's not like, just look at that stylish, because some content is supposed to be in other sections, of course. Well, that's because I already made some other schemes, and that I'm going to show you how to add another scheme. This is, let's go back and make a finish story. I made some other schemes, and if you apply them, it's gonna look like this website. It's gonna look completely the same as revamps.com, with the text like 100% width and two columns, etc., etc. So for that, it's a matter of doing some CSS, of course. I mean, if you compare this main with this main, it's completely different. One thing is, of course, this got a slider, which we gonna show you later. Because for now, we first gonna add some other scheme. Well, let's go to the FTP software. And I already made locally some other schemes in the Revamps. Let me see. Okay, it's only got the default. Well, I made here some other schemes, as you can see. And one of them, let me think, we can do that. what's pretty funny, it's schemes are managed in the backend of revamps by the schemes. You can see here this right now, this is the default scheme. You can deduplicate it, and I'll show you later on how to edit it. But if you add, for example, one by FTP, it will also show you again that scheme next to this one. So let's add there to the, I got to refresh it properly, to also add there the revamp 5, because we just installed it. And you notice it will just show it's on the server. It will show here the default scheme, which is also up here. If we add another one, for example, gonna be okay. For example, resensed. That's gonna be okay. I mean, I always do these videos freestyle, so no preparation, no nothing at all. We can edit, takes some while, and as you notice, a scheme is not more than some images, like an image for the Facebook meta image, some header, it's probably now resensed, SVG version, which I use pretty much nowadays, because it's a vector. They got a scheme CSS. It's pretty minimal CSS, as most of the CSS is already done with revamps. I mean, revamps takes care for round corners, for gradients, for bevels, for instant emboss, for transparency, stuff like that. So you don't have to do it in your scheme. You can do it with scheme editor, which I'm going to show you in a while. And another file, that's the values files, which you, in a way, don't have to touch any single character for, which is generated also by the scheme editor, and which I'll show you later. And this one knows how to, for example, what to apply to certain areas, which I'll kind of show you later. And of course, some web fonts which you can choose from the scheme editor. So now we added resensed, which I'm gonna rename, because I don't like I can show you that in the revamps configuration. So we go back to the web store and website, to the configuration, and we go to schemes, and you notice the resensed scheme is added to it. But I don't want to have it there named, although it fits the domain, so let's keep it like this. We call it resensed. And this one got a little bit different layout. Actually, it's the same as this layout, but it's named resensed. So let's apply this scheme to the website. For that, we go to the website, and we go to resensed, and select this one into save. Let's reload the whole thingy, and here we go again. That's annoying cookie policy. Well, I'll show you later on how it's been done. And notice the design is already like, more like the what's more hot nowadays, more the horizontal based layout. And also menu has been changed, it's on top. And the cut is even just nice like this. So this is done by changing the scheme. So we choose here what scheme it will have. I'll give you another example. Let's try to baby blue. But notice like the pages and the sections were already set up for the resense scheme. But to give you an example about the flexibility, let's add baby blue. You don't notice it's uploading. Let's go back to the backend, refresh it. And notice there's the baby blue. If you go to here and we choose baby blue to save and we reload the website, notice we got this fancy baby blue website. And of course, the content isn't made for this particular template, but you notice it's got a different style. It's more, let's call it baby, more sweet. Round corners, it got some other fonts. Stuff like that. But of course, the menu items don't fit this template because it are too much. But that was about to give you an idea about how it's been done. So let's change back to recent again and save it. One thing I just think about, and that's what you get with this freestyle finish, is that if you got some problems, and I mean that's just after the installation. I mean, some remembering. We in the beginning we added this domains, but if it still doesn't work properly, then you have to add, and that's in a way you have to do it if you wanna. With one site it doesn't matter that much, but if you wanna make real, if you really wanna use the features of Revamped 5, which means the multiple websites, you really need to add the config modification. And that's in a way pretty simple. If you got 2H3, copy this code. I mean, this is some side story. Copy this code and paste it in the config file of Website Baker. So that's where you usually change the database name and username and password. If you got 284, which is a little bit different with this, because it's got an ini file which uploads to the config, copy this part, copy it, and of course I already did it in the beginning because this site was already running. But to show you where it is, go to the config, which is in the root of Website Baker, and you'll notice this is in a way the same file, nothing changed. Change it and just paste it there. And this is different than when you have a normal Website Baker install, because it's in the new Website Baker this is empty. This file is empty. It's only like for the time being, because it's going to be depreciated in future. But for now, this is going to be work fine. And just paste this in the config file. I already did it, so that's why I was quickly looking over it. Back to the Revamped thingies, the schemes. So we were at like having this nice thingy applied. I already again applied the resense. If we refresh it, there's the resense. Well, then maybe some of you just kind of ask like questions like, okay, you said it's going to be the same like this website, which got like a rating, a share buttons, which actually really work. For example, share it to Facebook. It will always give you this light box over it, because that's more what I think of having a nicer user experience. As usually when you click this button, you get this pop-up from Facebook, and now you have like one light box in between. And of course you can just share it on Facebook if you wanna, and it goes to the Facebook page. But if you go back, you still have this. So you keep your customers or clients or visitors, you keep them on your site, and you have this nice more quiet user experience. So some of you will say like, okay, you got all these buttons, social media, blah blah blah, Okay, let's have a look at it. And the fourth, of course, also the slider. I mean, it's kind of naked like this. Even if there's no naked. Okay. So let's check it out. There's some content is there. Some is right place also, and of course also the modules work properly because that was already pre-made. To add features, for example, and that's a nice thing of revamps. It already got this rating, share buttons, latest news, social media contact, Google Maps, for example. It already got it in website bay or in revamps already pre-made. So that's pretty nice, and I'm gonna show you how to activate this kind of buttons. Or I better say boxes, because we call them boxes with revamps. And for that we go again to the revamps configuration. And if you're like, okay, what about switching all the time? It's a little bit confusing. Let's close this one. And maybe also close the whole website bake thing, because in a way we don't need it anymore. Because what's also nice on revamps, it got its own, and don't let it distract you by resense, because it's just like for an example, because this is still the real template framework here on top. It got this dashboards on top, which, for example, looks a bit, some of them who's maybe familiar with WordPress know this kind of dashboard thingy. And it got, for example, the edit page. Now that's different with Website Baker, because this is what WordPress doesn't have. That's like we can edit the page from the front end very nicely. And in a way, it just opened the page, for example, if you go to the configuration, and we get rid of this annoying box, of course. If you want to add this page, you just choose edit, and you got this page, and you can just edit it directly full screen in a lightbox. It's for, of course, very nice, and also for editors of the website, it's very user friendly. Well, you can go directly to the settings, the sections, to, for example, the media. But another one, we can also go directly to the configuration. That makes it, of course, more easy to work with, because we can just like go to the configuration from in the front end. And if you, for example, got editors who may not access this, you can, as an admin, of course, say, well, do you want to show the configuration in the front end? Just uncheck this. Do you want to at least have a front end dashboard, yes or no? Well, you can select it here and save it if you want. So it won't show up the configuration in the scheme editor in the front end, for example. For now, we go to the website again, because as you see, with revamps, it's really like the content and the system of Website Baker, and let's call it the framework, are really, in a way, two thingies. I mean, revamps is on top of it, and you can here manage multiple websites, but also a lot of front-end features. Well, I'm not gonna talk about all of them. This is gonna be a short movie for my talking, which means it's gonna be under an hour. There's a lot of functions. I go very fast with them. You can redirect devices. If you can't, for example, revamps can detect a mobile device, an iPad, a tablet, a normal website, and you can redirect them. You can also, for example, if you want to redirect a mobile device, you can say, okay, redirect it to a certain URL. And this can be, of course, be another website in your in Website Baker, or in revamps, of course, with pages in Website Baker. And that's different with responsive. I mean, as people say, yeah, responsive is the thing. Well, for me personally, as a designer, I think redirective is the thing, because you can really deliver tailored design to a mobile device, and not like some flexible interface which is kind of, I'd say it's, yeah, it's kind of relative how it will show up on certain devices. So you can really make a tailored website and redirect to it. And you can also say like, okay, does the tablet have to redirect to the mobile? Yes or no? Because mostly on the tablet you can also view the full website, of course. So mostly it's like this is on none, this on no, and this of course you can redirect to to a certain mobile website. Just check out revamps.com and you show you'll notice the difference. And another thing is like if you are on the mobile website, you can also like if someone sends an URL sends a mobile URL to by for example email to someone on desktop, it will just redirect from the mobile website to the desktop version again. So it goes vice versa, it goes from mobile to tablet and tablet to mobile. That's something pretty neat. Of course, you can per website you can put their SEO description and site keywords. You want robots to follow them, yes or no? It's a meta tags. It's sort of Facebook meta tags. This gives you some more information to systems or search engines. And of course, we can have a slider box, which we see here. I mean, this is a certain slider. I think this is, if I'm right, this is the Pikachu slider. Or no, it's the unslider slider. And there's like five types of sliders in revamps. With me count six of them, which you can choose from here. So, for example, if you choose unslider, of course, this is not really fair, but it's already there. It of course needs its pictures. You see, you cannot upload any pictures here, and that's pretty neat again, because the slider images come from the caption slider, which is well known in Webster Baker for making an image slider. It's a caption slider, which is out of the box pretty, let's call it default. Well, all these slide effects work on top of a caption slider. And the only thing you need to do, if you go to, and that's pretty handy for here, go to the admin and you go to caption slider, you notice the pictures are here already. And they're in a certain group, resense, EA. And they got a certain size, like 590, blah blah. Well, let me go again to the configuration, to the website, the slider box. Well, that name of that group we put in here. So that's where, that's why there was like, a slider resensed. EN, if I'm right. That's this name. We kind of put it here. This group is going to be the group of images. You can also put that speed in seconds. Well, it's not milliseconds, so no difficult counting in thousands, just like seconds. How long we want to have the effect? 1 second. We want a slight delay. Well, let's give it some slight delay of 4 seconds. And a page ID to display the slider on. Well, that's something I don't know out of my head. But the idea is like if you put here an ID of a page, it will only show on that page. If you leave it empty, the slider will be shown on all pages. So for now, it's nice just to save it like this. And we can go again from the dashboard, we choose reload. And notice, still a picky thing, the slider's here. On in a way, every page we go. Maybe you notice it isn't moving. Oh, okay, there it goes. Needs some time. But this is the unslider, so there's no arrows with this one, but they can like you can move it with the arrows, and it's also show because it's kept probably pretty long, slight delay of a few seconds. There it goes. So this is the on slider. Let's change it to some other slider. For example, the box slider tiles. I cannot guarantee that it's gonna look very nice, because of course you always need to customize the slider a little with CSS, of course. Like this one is not sent yet. You need to do that with CSS. So, but the effect is there. It's a 3D tile slider effect. And on the Mac, it shows this line. But I heard on PC and stuff like that, and Firefox, it doesn't show them. So it's a Safari thing. So you can choose multiple slider effects just from the revamped backend. So no installation of other scripts and putting things in your template. Just choose one of these, and you can also extend it pretty easy by yourself as well. Scripting base, using caption slider of this is already there. You can extend it easily by adding some by FTP. And as you can see, it's pretty modular built. And for example, you have sliders. You see all these sliders is here. And it's mostly just like jQuery scripts with some PHP file. And maybe you need to add some in the CSS file. But the whole thing is like modular. You add some and it will automatically appear in this menu. Let's choose for now the Pikachus. Save it again, because I know that one is for now pretty okay with this website. And okay, we're also gonna get rid of this annoying thing. Well, you see, this one looks very nice. It almost seems like there was already a thought of how to implement it in this template. You notice this looks really nice already, of course, optimized some typographic stuff with it. So. And let's get rid of that annoying cookies thing. Okay, there's a lot. I'm gonna show you this one first. I wanna get rid of this cookie thing. So this is cookie warning, just put it for no. You can also leave them yes, and like if people don't agree with it, they go to some other URL. But for now, maybe, yeah, that's where it's not really applicable, of course. Of course, there are cookies, but they're not like for distance tracking. So, slider box. There's other things like you want to have a search box, you want to have a login box, maybe you want to have a login box. And you notice like that's a thing I'm gonna optimize in future versions. You notice here like there's terms like in left sidebar top, in left sidebar bottom, in right sidebar top, in right sidebar bottom, and in the footer. Well, if you look at the website with this scheme, it doesn't have a left or right sidebar anymore. That's because the CSS made the left and right sidebar like 100% width. And actually, this is a sidebar, and I think the box below here is another sidebar. You won't see it because there isn't anything in it. And that's flexibility. I'm going to do something about the names in future version, as future version had a left and right sidebar in the content area. So it can be maybe a little bit confusing, but in a way it's not, because just a matter of adding something like, okay, let's put the login box in the left sidebar top. And you notice it will appear. I'm also curious with this thing. Okay, it's here in the bottom, in the top. So, and it's 100% width, so it's kind of strange. But of course there has to be something else for this kind of template. And that's the one you can have the login box, for example, for clients to log in. In the footer. And if you place in the footer, and you load the website again, you notice this little tiny key in the footer. Well, if you click on it, you get this nice login box with you are now logged in, of course, but if you log out, you notice there's the login box for the name and the password. So this is like very subtle login box. Okay, still some 10 minutes, otherwise the hour is getting too long. So pick out a slider on every page. Let's see if we only can put it on the main. It's a little bit annoying, of course. And as you can see, main get page ID 2. So let's go to the configuration. Slider box show only on page 2. What coincidence was already there. And if we reload now, you notice like this page doesn't have the slider anymore, but only in the menu. It's like a fixed menu, or better say a sticky menu, sticks to the top. And only in the main it has the slider. Well, if you look already to the revamped website, it's already started to look like a little bit the same. Huh? But still, this one got its boxes in the footer, and we only got this text. So let's put that a rating box. Therefore, we go to the configuration again and let's add some page rating. Well, as you can see, all the boxes, I call them boxes, are default or on nowhere, because in that case they don't appear nowhere. For now, already said, like you can put it in the left or the right sidebar, which are now vertical or let's say horizontal boxes which lay on top of each other, so one is above the other. Well, there's also a below content area, which really says what it does. And this is like below the content area, so below everything. If you put there, for example, the page rating box with nice red stars. You can choose if you want to have the PNG files or SVG files. Well, I choose SVG because they look much more nice and sharp. And here we can see how much ratings per IP address we want. One is, of course, common, two is still quite fair, and with 10 is definitely fraud. So let's do the fair one. And you can add there the microdata rating speciality, which sounds very sophisticated, and that also is, because these stars got microdata attached to them, so Google knows it's a rating, it's a so-called official rating, and the stars will also show up in the Google ranking. So sometimes you see this website with these stars next to it, and it looks very nice in your Google ranking, of course. If you see like so many votes out of this much votes, or let's say this so many rating about this this much votes. Well, to give Google even more extra, I call it food. You can add a speciality. So let's say this recent website is about revamps template. Website Baker Website Baker and it's of course framework. In this case Google knows the ranking is about something they got to do with, well, some template framework and Website Baker, so it are in a way sort kind of keywords. But very little one. That's why this field is not big. You only need to have to put there only a few. Well, let's save this. and reload it again. And guess what's there? There's the rating box. And of course there's already some rating. I cheated a little because it got to look like something, right? But the rating box is there and you can both rate it. And it will know if you already rated it 2 times, for example. Some other thing, like all these text you can change. And let's do some side thing again. Languages you can change in the reference framework in the language folder. Every language, and at the moment it comes in 3 languages. It will detect it to your language of your website. And for example, for all these words, there's this language file, and you can change them whatever you wanna. Share Facebook, share LinkedIn, whatever. Here's like rating, awesome, excellent, very good, good and fair. These are just like what's written here. So every word, except the content, of course, you can translate or make your own, give your own word. So that's one. What did we have more here? There's some share box, of course. This is the share page box. Very well. Also put it below the content area. And it's pretty nice because there's already like icons. What kind of icons you want to show them? There's let's for this one. There's only one SVT set yet, like the monocolors. Pretty nice. Every social media every sharing media got its own icon in its own colors. But they also come like mono light, so these are kind of white logos, dark logos. For now, let's choose this SVG monocolor. 32 pixels. I do want to have some text displayed to it. Let's do it. What the heck? And let's see how cute. You notice this icon is also displayed in here. And for example, if you go to the real revamp website, I choose a darker version, you notice that icon is also here. So it knows which icon is used. So you can, in a way, make your own. Though it is already like the same schemes, it already looks like different. And of course, you can also edit some own effects with it. With, for example, the CSS. Well, the other two I won't do for now. Still got 2 minutes. But I can show you some from the revamp site. It's pretty nice. You can also, for example, add a contact box with a form. For that, of course, you need to put there your own. Let's go to the configuration. You, of course, put there your email address in. And we do that in the contact box. Again, you can show it where. Well, you can put in your phone number, email, street, postal code, and depending on this, so if you put a phone number, you can be pretty smart. It will show this icon. If you don't put in your phone number, it won't show this icon. And if you put it there, you get this light box with calls directly. And of course, you can change this. The same with the email. If you put out the email, it will give you this email button. If you put at the street, it will give you this Google Map thingy. And also it puts at this address. This whole thing with the address, put it in here. You can also put it, of course, some other place. But mainly, just put this here. This whole Google thing. And right now I only say like there's a city and a land and a country. But if you put that whole address, like with the street, it also show exactly the particular point on the street, of course. The same with the social media. which you should not mix up with the share box. The sharing is like share a page on a certain media, and that's our, this is like the default. There's always like the Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Google, and email. That's pretty nice. You put your email, you can, in a way, it's a tell a friend. Put your own name, your own email, and then some of the three other people, and they all get the link of this particular page in their email. Now, this is all the same, but the social media is like this. And this links like directly to your to a certain social media. Except the QR code, which you can also QR code generates a real time QR code, and which you can like scan with your smart device and go to, for example, the mobile website, or put there some action or some card information, just some IDs. That can be done with the social media box, and just putting here like your Facebook, the name of the Facebook page, the URL, the LinkedIn page, and you don't have to put there the domain, just put there the name of the page, and it's okay. Reframe knows it's about Facebook, and it's pretty much at the moment, like 23 if I'm right. You can put, for example, your QR code message. So RSS. Some other thing I want to show. Well, what's also pretty nice is this V-card. I mean, if you add this information here, or better say, in the backend, your contact information, it'll also automatically make a V-card link. And as you click it, it will get downloaded. Also works, by the way, on mobile phones. And if you download it, you notice it's a V-card format. And if you preview it, it loads automatically the phone number, the email, the address, and some note like, okay, you got a V-card from the Revamped Template Framework for Webster Baker website. And that's because, of course, this came from the Revamped website. But if you call it another name, if you call your website another name, and that's the name of the website in the configuration, it shows this name up here. And a date. So it's pretty neat. And you can, for example, on the Mac, you can directly add it to your contacts folder, or to your contacts application. So it's kind of, or better say, very advanced template framework. And one thingy I want to show you still, and then I'm gonna end this video. It's scheme editor, because like, okay, it's nice, the schemes, but how, of course, do you style them? I mean, the layout is done by CSS, but the coloring, for example, if you see this, these colors aren't done by CSS. They're done, and that's the button I didn't touch all the time, the scheme editor. And that's in a way the same. You can also access scheme editor from the schemes. I mean, if you press edit, you go to the scheme editor. You can edit this or that or some particular scheme. Well, right now we got a resense. We can edit them here all. But if you go like from this dashboard, you can directly edit the resense scheme. And you see like it maybe doesn't look like the scheme at all. I mean, in some ways there's a logo, there's a menu bar, but in a way it looks like, because it's all the colors of this schemes or all these boxes, or areas, divs, and fonts, and stuff like that. So I'll show you a little, because this is really like nice play thing. That's the whole thing with the schemes. In a way, I already told you there are like skins, and there are even some version control. Like if you update the scheme, you can give it another version. You can give it some description if you wanna. And it's got a lot of options again, which I'm not gonna talk about right now. got a lot of options which affect the front end GUI. For example, page title, you can have some text resizer. If you want to have page loader, yes or no. Should there be accountability notification, like if there's some browser is too old? Well, Internet Explorer is always too old. So, but at least you can say like it should be newer than EA9, or it should be like newer than EA11. Some layout areas you want to show. You want to show a left side column, right side. You want to show them the menu, etc. You can give the typography colors, and that's what I'm, for example, can show you a little. Of course, it should load properly. Oh, it should be this color thingy beneath. Let's refresh it again. I think it's not loaded or something. It can be even worse, the internet connection is not... Well, this is the thing about the internet connections. Let's try it again. It's not working. Okay, that comes again. Well, it's, that's pretty funny. Well, it's a kind of bad internet connection lately up here. But what I want to show you is like you can real time change colors, for example. And for now, I'm gonna use this scheme on this. So I can play around with it. For example, you can change around with it, save it, and I change like the H1. Then you go back to the website, and there, if there are use any H1. No, not let me see. Yeah, there's some H2. I'll change some random colors, like because for now I don't know exactly which I used. It can be used some H3, so I guess you like pretty fancy colors. No one knows them how they change. Reload page. Okay, there they are. So it's you can see like if you change let's call it the major thing, major colors and font colors, for example, and also the fonts can be changed by the scheme editor. And there's also kind of all the fonts you can change. You can change the button colors, for example. I give them nice colors like this. I mean, I had them in colors, but yeah, you can give them your own colors, of course. So that's pretty nice with schemes. They're in a way a layout with already predefined colors, which you can make your own modifications to it. And that's like, okay, it's nice. But what about the backgrounds? Well, for that you need to uncheck the live preview and notice some options, some words is appearing. If you see this is like a real template, if you uncheck it, the names of the areas will show up. For example, the body background color. Well, you can change it like easily. We can change the site container color. I better say, let's give the, oh, that was the body, the side container left, let's give the side container another color, or even better, let's give the gradients. What about some gradients? It goes from the bottom, which is red, till like up, kind of pinky, and save it. And reload it. well, some colors maybe aren't shown. You see here some blue because they're beneath some other boxes, of course. But you see the menu is really pretty trippy colors. Let's do some more major blocks, like the sidebars. Let's give the sidebar a color, like bluish, and reload it again. And then you also notice what's like the sidebar used to be like from top to bottom, or here's like from left to right. So this is the sidebar. It's like more 100% width. Well, I think this is gonna be it for now. Of course, this you can really play around this kind of stuff. I mean, there's so many options in the revamps, which I won't show you, but it's gonna be a 2-hour video in that case. Some more thingies, you can add round corners pretty easy. You can add like a gradient, as already said. There's 14 pre-made gradients inside, which are pretty nice colors, if you ask me. Yes, you can add drop shadow toolbox, like from 6 pixels till 10 to 15. This can be applied on most of the boxes. You notice this got like, it's called CSSP. They all got this. The banner can even have a background, but also got the CSSP. It can be an inset emboss or inset shadow, how do you want to call it? They can get transparent. So this can be applied to almost all of the boxes. Looks kind of nice, huh? Only one thing I want to show you, and that's the header. That's the header for the website right now, and you can like easily change it to something. Well, let's change the background color. Maybe there's some thing we don't see. Is there some? Oh, there's some icon. It's a little icon that's also in the images folder, but it you won't show. You won't notice it at the moment. Well, if you put it on repeat, you'll notice the icon. If you can't, for example, put it on no repeat, and right now it's left center, let's put it on right top, it's here. Put it on the right center, it's centered from vertical centered. So it's pretty nice what can be done, and if you take another background color again, it's got reset again, but that's a minor issue. There's it again. So you can do a lot already from the scheme editor and make it a really nice and fancy website. Well, let's see what it's gonna be. I mean, so it's easier to that's a cute website. Wow. Of course, it's always easier to damage something than to make it nice. But at least I got some backup from the scheme, so it's easy to be being updated again. But you can see how flexible it is to work with the scheme editor and make it like from without touching any code or CSS, just already add like some very nice very effective styling to it. For now, I think we got already. No, this is what I want to show you. I'm gonna put back again as I copied it luckily. And the only thing that got changed right now is the values file. That's pretty funny. So all the colors, all the images, all that kind of stuff is done in the values file. We didn't touch the scheme CSS, which can be done. I mean, you can, and that's really the last thing I'm going to say. You can even edit the CSS file of this particular scheme, which is not much. I mean, for those who know about CSS, you notice it's got, let's see, some width, for example. It got the content area top, the sidebar content area, the content container, just say it like width, the height and stuff like that. The side containers are like 100% width. And you can edit it from here, you can save it, and it will like, it will be like updated. But for now, that's pretty fast. I put again back the value file, as I quite like it more when it was like before. So if you now like refresh the website again, it will be like how it's supposed to be. So that was like from the default website maker template till a revamped 5 based scheme. This is the movie for now. I'm gonna do some other movie later on, but I'll let you know. Check you later.